By now, you should have heard about all the cool things that ServiceNow is doing in the domain of generative AI. So today, we're just going to focus on a key subset of that, which is Now Assist for Creator. And in particular, we'll take a look at text to code as well as text to flow. This instance I currently have is on Vancouver Patch 4, and we are within App Engine Studio. So I've pre-created a super simple application here to track expense claims. There are just two tables. The first is the expense claim table where users will submit their expense claims on. And there's actually a reference from this table to a claim category table, which is the master table that stores all the different claim types. And within each claim type, there is a claim limit as well. Back to that later, but just for your information, these are things like airfares, meals, transport allowances, and more. So this is also what the form looks like. I know it's super basic, but it is going to be the foundation into which we introduce all these generative AI capabilities. The first thing I would like to do is to automatically default the expense date to today. And obviously this is for a better user experience. So a client script will probably work the best here. We'll go ahead and create one. I'll give it a very simple name here, default expense date to today. Change the UI, change the client script type to onload. And now we get into the fun part, which is looking at the script block. So traditionally what you would do is go start writing a script, right? Of course. But now you can see here, there are two stars, one big, one small one, both in purple, in the form of an icon here. And this tells you that Now Assist for Code Generation is actually enabled here. So what we have to do next is to enter the description in the form of comment of what we're going to achieve via this client script. So I enter here, if the expense date is empty, then set that date to today. Command enter or control enter on a PC. And what will happen is that it will magically go to LLM or LLM and generate the script for you according to what you've asked for. Super cool, isn't it? You will also notice that not only is the code generated, but there's actually auto completion of my code comment as well. So it just says that it adds in today's date, not just today. So a little bit clearer. And this extends to not only comments, but even to code as well. So if you're writing code, in the middle of it, you want it to complete the code for you with possible outcomes and possible examples, you could use this as well. So we're done here. Let's go check out what we have achieved. Refreshing this form, you will see that the date now populates to today. Easy peasy, that's all done within a matter of seconds. So that's super cool. And before you start judging all you master architects and technical architects out there, do remember that there are people like me who struggle with code. I'm not technically trained. I didn't come from a development background. So even the idea of accelerating code for client scripts, business rules, it's such a game changer for me. Also think about the people who are new to the ServiceNow ecosystem, who are starting out their careers as developers. This is such a time improvement for them. I don't need to go community anymore, work my way through all the different articles and even ask questions there, right? A lot of that is being done for me with text to code. I want to try another scenario for a business rule. And this time I want to enforce that the user's submitted claim amount is less than the allowable limit that is stored in the claim category table. Sounds a little bit more complicated than just a basic date set. So that's what we're going to try to achieve here. So I'll call these validate expense limit, click the insert and update, and the advanced checkbox to get our script box up here. Once again, you'll notice that the code generation capability Now Assist is now available there because the icon's there as well. And this time we are going to enter our description. In the claim category reference, get claim limit. If the claim amount is less than the claim, that's not right. Validate that the claim amount is greater than the claim limit. Right. So With that, again, once again, this time, instead of a client script, it's able to intelligently pick out the context that I'm within the business rule, and the script changes according to that. So you don't have to worry so much about the syntax anymore. This helps you along in that perspective. So I'll go ahead and accept this. If you want, you can just take a quick pause and just see what the output of this code is. All I'm going to do is change the comments here to make it a little bit more readable, a little more understandable to the end user, right? So letting them know that the limit was burst or did not adhere to the amount because of the expense category. So I'll update this business rule. Go ahead and submit that. And let's go and test it out. So since we are in a business rule, there is no need for me to refresh the screen. And this time I will choose the category here, which is taxi. And we can see that the claim amount limit that we set was $50. Okay. What I will do is enter an amount slightly higher than that. So let's try $50.20. Submit this, and straight away, our claim was not able to be submitted, because we have breached the level of the expense limit or the claim limit, right? With the message there that we entered or edited when we actually added in the business rule. Super cool stuff. So text to code, you can use it in fixed scripts. You can use it in script includes. You could even use it within Action Designer, right? Even when you have a script view in Action Designer or Flow Designer, you can use Now Assist for code generation over there. So super powerful, and it will only continue to get better. The other feature that I want to talk about today, and one that is very new, I'm still learning the ropes around it, but there isn't much to learn. Again, this is generative AI. That is Flow Designer, so text to flow. So you can see here I'm in Flow Designer, and when I create a new flow, you will now be able to see a box here that gives you two options. You can build from scratch, which is a traditional way of building a flow in Flow Designer, or you can build with Now Assist. What I would then do is to call this claim expense claim workflow, and I can start writing my prompts for what that workflow look like. So when an expense claim is submitted, email the user that the claim has been received. I'm not great at typing here. Then ask their managers for approval. If the manager approves, change the status to approved and inform the user via email. If rejected, send an email. Yeah, I think that's all at here. I'm purposely leaving out update record here to see what generative AI does in this case. So let's go ahead and click on build with Now Assist. Give it a couple seconds, it's doing its magical thing in the back end. And in a matter of seconds here, we're gonna have the flow generated for us. Right. So looking at the flow, it has built everything that we have described, but also interestingly included the update record under rejected. Oh, that's awesome. Yes, so really quickly, we are able to get these outcomes, and we gave it quite a few different steps for instruction, right? It's able to understand every part of that and break it down here. I see very accurately into the different steps that we have asked for. So if we wanted to, then we can start plugging in all these different data fields. For example, in the created, we can choose the expense claim for the record trigger, and you can go ahead and edit the email actions, the ask for approvals, update records and everything else. I think let's go ahead and try and delete this update record action. And I wanted to show you another feature here, which is flow recommendations. Now, again, this has been out for some time, but in case you haven't seen it, this gives you the next best action. And taking in context the rest of the workflow here, what you might want to use in that sense. So this very quickly gets us the right action that we need. I'll choose update record again, and I'll just drag in the rest here, and I just need to complete these. Putting a claim status, changing that to rejected as per our flow that we have described, right? So, well, that was all I had for you today. And I really hope you see the power of this in the direction that we are taking with building applications and building workflows and building logic these days. It's no longer about spending your time thinking so much about how you build code or build flows, but getting to objectives so much quicker. So let me know what you think, and this time truly, no code, no problem.